How can anyone love a pebble in their shoe? And if you don't understand that reference to Ever After, then instead I will start this video with "What is a youth?" And if you don't understand that reference, well, I don't know what to do. For the past few weeks, I've had two different cravings, if you will. I wanted to make something red, and I also wanted to make something renaissance-y. But I didn't have any red fabric, so both of those ideas were not doable. But eventually, I did get something red from somebody, and I made sure to get permission first before cutting it up. When it came to inspiration, I definitely really liked Juliet's dress from the 1968 Romeo and Juliet. And also this dress worn by Danielle in my favorite film of all time, Ever After. I actually found this pattern somebody made online, and it's actually for Danielle from Ever After. And I was mostly focusing on this piece because it was the most similar to Juliet. The person who made this pattern posted this picture. This is how the result turned out. But you can see that this and this are not exactly the same, so I traced the pattern and I modified it. And then I cut it out, and I took this vest, and I ripped out the lining! Although it's reversible, so maybe that's not the lining, but whatever. And then I made these pieces, and I took my puffy sleeve pattern that I already had. And then for the rest of the sleeves, I cut out two triangles, I mean rectangles, whoops. And then I ended up with this. And then came the skirt. I used the skirt pattern from the Ever After pattern the person posted, and I cut out the skirt, like so, but I accidentally cut into my tablecloth, which honestly I was expecting to happen. This is one way to gather a skirt. You do a running stitch, and then you pull it, and you gather the fabric. This is usually not how I do it, actually, and if it crashes and burns, then it crashes and burns. Well, it didn't crash and burn, but it didn't, take flight, I guess. So, gotta start over, and do it how I usually do it, by doing pleats. Also, have some videos of me struggling with sewing machines, because sewing machines are... sometimes they work, and sometimes they don't. I really thought it would be easy to sew in the pleats using the sewing machine, but then this happened, and this happened, so doth thine eyes deceive me, or do machines suck? Also, during this project, I had a flashback to a video game I played where one character spoke kind of in a spoof of Shakespeare. So I did it by hand, and eventually I ended up with this. And I thought that I could do something fancy, so I went back to the machine, and I tried some fancy stitches. Fortunately, it turned out pretty good. As you can see, the hem is, well, fancy. So it was looking pretty good, but I honestly found the sleeves kind of boring, and so I took this gold trim that I got a long time ago for another costume, and I thought I could put it on the sleeves, but then it disintegrated. But then I scavenged some string from the pieces, and I put them on the sleeves, and it looks nice. I still thought something was missing, like Oliver Warbucks, and so I put a piece of scrap fabric in the bodice. Presto! Bingo! Voila! All that jazz.